Oh, thank you, Rachel. Look at this. I love Christmas. And the most exciting thing for me at Christmas is to get a book and be able to unwrap it. So I'm going to open this one in a minute. I'm looking at another book at the moment. It's called The Trouble with Women by Jackie Fleming. And this is cartoons about women's lot, largely in the 19th century. Here's a really good bit. Girls who weren't servants, slaves or coal miners were far too fragile for schooling, but they could always eavesdrop if they had brothers. But eavesdropping was hampered by the hairdos which covered up the ears. So this is a great one to give. It's the sort of thing you can keep in the loo at Christmas when you've eaten too much food. You can rush in and start reading that. Other things that I'm going to be giving out and looking at Christmas, Palaces for the People, How to Build a More Equal and United Society. I'm sending this to Donald Trump and Bolsonaro in Brazil. They're on my Christmas list. What's this? Aristotle's Way, How Ancient Wisdom Can Change Your Life. And God knows we need our lives changed. But Edith Hall is a fantastic classicist. She's a friend of mine, so yeah, I am pushing her book, but actually only because it's good. Otherwise, I'd be embarrassed and I'd put it under the table. What else have we got here? The wonderful Hugh Warwick, Lionscapes. He's my favourite man about hedgehogs, and if you love hedgehogs, which I do, this is the book for you. One of my favourite memoirs this year, Educated by Tara Westover. This will have you laughing, crying. This is the absolute antidote to all your relatives. And what's here? Nobody should go through Christmas, right, without Yuval Noah Harari, 21 Lessons for the 21st Century. Again, another wise, spiritual book, the sort of thing you want to read when you're thinking about what the new year should be instead of just stuffing your face with pies. What have we got here? We've got The Wife, Meg Wallett. So you could just go and see the movie and then buy the book as well. One of my favourite ones, absolutely favourite ones, I'm sending this to Harvey Weinstein for Christmas. How to Be Successful Without Hurting Men's Feelings. Non-threatening leadership strategies for women. They are, of course, always jokes. And so you can see pictures of yourselves being threatening if you say, I'd like to be considered for a promotion, or non-threatening, I think you should consider Alison for promotion. This is great. How to Be Harassed Without Hurting His Career. And for the serious ones among you, now you're talking, a history of human conversation from the Neanderthals to artificial intelligence. I'm very interested in machine learning and how machines will actually interact in a non-sexist way, because at the moment, of course, machines are being taught by rather sexist, geeky guys. And so, you know, it's worse than a parrot. You know, we used to have a parrot in the station where I get on the train to come to London, and all it ever said was, fuck off. And that's because all the station master ever said to it. The same will happen with machine learning if we're not careful. That's it. And if you wanted some classics, I mean, either you could use these to bash the pastry with, or you could read them. Anna Karenina, Tolstoy, of course, and War and Peace. Beautiful things, doorstops, long books for the long Christmas holiday. But what's in here? This is the bit I'm interested in, because my friend Rachel has given me a gift. She's also wrapped it up in a way which suggests that she spent time in Japan. I wonder if I can even get in it. Let me just rip it apart. I don't know. I wrap all my presents in copies of the FT at Christmas because it allows people to read interesting articles about their financial health, and it saves the planet and it saves money. And I tie them up with gardening string because it's very cheap. Right, what's in here? Oh, look at this, perfect. Now, this has got to be the best one because I wrote it. Christmas Days, and this is 12 stories and 12 recipes by me for the Christmas season. I love this little book. Why do I love it? Because most Christmases I write just for myself a Christmas story, because I like telling myself stories. It cheers me up. When I was a kid growing up, Christmas was the only time in our household that was happy. Mrs. Winterson miraculously became happy on December 21st and back to her normal, miserable, apocalyptic self on January 2nd. So that period for me was golden and lit up, and I've carried it with me. So if you want something that is just fun over Christmas, read these stories. There are snow women that come to life. There are flying reindeers. There are couples who get together. There are elves. There are all kinds of magical things going on, and some great recipes, including my dear departed friend Ruth Rendell's red cabbage. And we've all lost people at Christmas, haven't we? But the loved ones are there in spirit. You invite everyone to your table. And take a tip from me. Nigella gave it to me, and it's a good tip. If you've got awful relatives and they have to come at Christmas, invite somebody you don't know very well, and they'll be your human shield. Merry Christmas, everybody.